Has anyone believed us or seen the mighty power of the Lord in action? Like a young plant or a root that sprouts in dry ground, the servant grew up obeying the Lord. He wasn't some handsome king. Nothing about the way he looked made him attractive to us. He was hated and rejected. His life was filled with sorrow and terrible suffering. No one wanted to look at him. We despised him and said, "He is a nobody." He suffered and endured great pain for us, but we thought his suffering was punishment from God. He was wounded and crushed because of our sins. By taking our punishment, he made us completely well. All of us were like sheep that had wandered off. We had each gone our own way, but the Lord gave him the punishment we deserved. Those words come from Isaiah 53, verses 1 to 6. In our modern world, these verses say something about Jesus that is really quite hard to accept. Jesus was not a handsome man. There was nothing about the way Jesus looked that made him attractive to those around him. The beauty that Jesus had was on the inside, not on the outside. So if you are spending your life trying to be physically attractive to others, then you are not being like Jesus in that pursuit. This is not to say that we shouldn't take care of our bodies and keep them clean and healthy if possible, but remember that nobody thought Jesus was physically attractive, and just looking at him caused them to think that he was a nobody. How you look is very important, but not how you look to men. Rather, how you look to God should concern your every moment. The Bible says that God doesn't judge you on how you look physically, but rather, God looks at your heart. If God sees a heart that is devoted to Jesus and willing and ready to do his will, then he is pleased with what he sees. With God, the condition of your physical body is not primarily important. Thank you, Lord, that I can be like Jesus without making my body beautiful in the eyes of other men. Create in me a clean heart and let me be more like you today than I have ever been before. And may you, Lord Jesus, be praised forever. Amen.